Eloheinu, Adonai, Echa, Baruch, Shem Kevo, Mai, Uto. Leolam vayed. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our Yah, the Lord is one. Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom. Forever and ever, all praises to the Most High Yah.
Yeah.
hallelujah this morning, the Most High. We get up this morning seeking him first, the kingdom of the Most High, Yah, and all his righteousness, knowing that all things shall be added unto us. Therefore, we come seeking, knocking, and asking, because we know the Bible is about a king in a kingdom. It's not a religious book. Yahushua did not come to bring you a religion. He came to give you an unshakable kingdom. Thou kingdom come, thou will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Come on now. Anything you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and anything you loose in the earth shall be loosed in heaven. The Most High Yah knew from the very beginning that his plan had never changed. From the time when Adam and Eve lost the kingdom, because see, they didn't lose heaven. Come on and wake up this morning. They didn't lose heaven. They lost a kingdom. So the Most High Yah's priority has always been the kingdom. Yahushua said, repent, for the kingdom of the Most High Yah is at hand. He also said, I give you the keys of the kingdom. We done got caught up in religion instead of relationship, and we don't even know the Most High Yah that we're serving. We've been serving pagan idolatry worship. We're in a modern day Babylon. We're in captivity right now. You better understand right now that we have to turn back to the laws, the commandments of the Most High Yah, if we want order in our lives. And you know, we always cry and we want order. You know, I love when they be like, order in the court, order in the court. See, the Most High Yah has made you legal. You are a law abiding citizen. He's made you legal. You're not a member of anything. You are a citizen. It's something about citizenship over membership. Mm-hmm. You better know in citizenship, you have rights and privileges. You have the principles of the Most High Yah. And we know if we take a principle and we apply that thing accurately, it would help us to prosper mentally, emotionally, physically, and financially. So if we apply the principles to our lives, we'll come out of dysfunction.
Yeah.
If we would get an understanding, you know, we always said, I'm saved, I'm saved, I'm saved. What are you saved from? Don't you understand that salvation is a lifestyle? Yahushua said, I came that you should have life, and that you should have life more abundantly.
Yeah.
It's about how do I live my life? The Torah is not law, it's teachings and instructions. Mm-hmm. See, it's not law until you break it. So we have to get an understanding that the Most High Yah has given us teachings and instructions. And his number one priority is the kingdom. Fear not, little flock, for it's my Father's desire to give you a kingdom. It's about a king and a kingdom. And we better understand that with everything that we have right now, going on right now in this United States of America, and like I said, we're in a modern day Babylon. And the plague is going on every single day. We know the number of deaths for coronavirus is going up. We know the hospital beds are running out. We know that. And so when we get that understanding that we're not in a pandemic, we're in a plandemic.
Yeah.
Amos chapter 8 says that there will come a day that we would be in a famine. And it's a famine not for bread nor meat nor drink, but for the word of the Most High Yah. Mm-hmm. And right now there's a famine going on. And we need to come out of darkness into his marvelous light. We need to know right now that the Most High Yah is bringing us to a crossroad right now. And he's letting us know that his word shall stand forever. We can't add to the Most High Yah's word, nor take away from his word. If we get an understanding of that, we will begin to walk in the entire Bible. Yahushua says, I come in the volume of the book. Mm-hmm. We can't just start in the New Testament, y'all. We have to know that the word starts in the beginning. In the beginning, the Most High Yah created the what? The heavens and the earth. Mm-hmm. And the earth was without form or void. And then what he do? He spoke the word into existence. Don't you know the power of life and death is in your tongue? Yeah. You're made in his image and his likeness. He spoke the word into existence. Mm-hmm. And we got to begin to speak some things in our lives right now. We have to know right now that we can decree a thing. Mm-hmm. When we begin to speak the word of the Most High. Yeah. It's all about the Most High. His teachings, his instructions, his direction, his protection. All of that is in the Torah. Mm-hmm. But see, we threw that out. Mm-hmm. And so we lost. It's like losing a compass on how to get somewhere or a GPS and you lost. We threw out our direction. Yes. We know the steps of a righteous man is ordered by the Most High Yah. And we want to say order our steps in his word. But you got to start in the beginning, from Genesis to Revelation. And you got to get an understanding that the Bible is not a religious book.
Come on.
It's about a king and a kingdom. Mm-hmm. And that is the Most High Yah's priority. And that's how we're going to walk.
Yes.
Now, and I know on this day, a lot of people, y'all celebrating Thanksgiving, happy Thanksgiving, happy Thanksgiving. You better go study that thing out from the origin. Mm. You know, you better know how that thing originated. All these pagan idolatry holidays that we celebrate, we don't even know why we're celebrating them. You better know what you're doing and why. That is so important. Mm-hmm. And you know, a lot of times we're on the heels of what they call Christmas. As the Most High says in Jeremiah, to not bring a tree into your house and decorate it. Mm. But we missed that part in Jeremiah. We missed all the warnings from the prophets. You better know right now, the word has to be established through the law, the prophets, and the writings. And if you got somebody is speaking the word and they're not standing on the law, prophets, and the writings, they're a false pastor, false bishop, false teacher, false evangelist. Mm-hmm. If they're not standing on the law, the prophets, and the writings. Mm-hmm. So we have to know how to study the word. He says to study to show thyself approved, a workman not needing to be made ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So we have to rightly divide the word of truth. Even Paul said by now we should be teachers, but who's teaching us? By now we should be teachers, but some of us need to go back to the first oracles of the Most High Yah. Mm-hmm. So come on in here this morning as we teach on the priority of the kingdom. I'm thanking him for what he's doing in our lives. I'm thanking him that the scales are falling off our eyes. I'm thanking him for this day, because this is the day that Yah has made and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I'm thanking him because this is what? The fifth day. I'm thanking him for those reasons, not about celebrating a pagan holiday. Hmm. That's what we're not going to do. So, not over here. We done came out of darkness now. When you come into light, when you begin to see, you know, you begin to put away those pagan gods.
Yes.
Especially when Yah says, there shall be no other gods before me. Mm-hmm. So we have to realize, you know, we all backsliding Israel. We Israel, stiff-necked folks, don't want to know the truth of the Most High. If we get the truth, we so stuck in our traditions that we don't know how to move. We're too stuck. We can't move. Mm. And so the Most High Yah is coming with teachings on 5 a.m. prayer to get you unstuck.
Yeah.
To get you to think about a thing. To get you to say, wow, well, maybe there's more to this Bible than I thought. It's not about religion. You mean to tell me it's about a king and a kingdom?
Hmm.
Well, it says he's King of Kings. And Most High Yah's of Most High Yah's. It says enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with prayer and praise. Everything in the word is about his law and about his kingdom. So we're going to walk and stand on kingdom principles for kingdom living.
Yeah.
And get an understanding of the word of the Most High Yah. Because the word says even the very elect would be deceived. You know, so many folks are deceived and thinking about this thing is about religion and not even knowing what his name is and not, you know, walking in scriptures that were originally written in Hebrew. You got to go back to an original thing.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want any hand-me-downs, knockoffs, and things like that. You want the original.
Yeah.
And scripture was originally written in Hebrew. So you want to study that thing out Hebraically.
Yes.
So the word says the very elect will be deceived. It says my people are destroyed from lack of knowledge. And then the Most High Yah says, I will no longer have you ignorant. You better come on into this kingdom mindset. Repent, for the kingdom of the Most High Yah is at hand. I will no longer have you ignorant of Hasatan devices. Come on, Israel. Wake up, Judah. You are from the tribe of Judah. You just need to wake up. Start studying. Start studying the word. Come on in here, Queen Gina Bokerto, beautiful one. You know, we got to study this thing like never before, so we're not being led astray. You know, they said in the word that many Christs will come, and they are already here now. And that was when Yahushua was speaking. So don't you know he was telling us then that the very elect would be deceived? We've been deceived by some teachings that we've listened to.
Yeah.
We've been deceived by walking in religion. Come on in here, King Reynard Bokerto. Bless you, King. Bless you. So we've been deceived because we did not study for ourselves. You know, we just sat there. I'm thinking half the time we didn't even open our Bibles. We just kind of sat there. But you got to become a seeker. And that's what the Most High Yah is telling you right now. Seek me while I may be found. Seek me. I mean, you got to search, search, search until your search becomes a seek. And you are on a journey with the Most High Yah in a relationship like never before. And the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, will lead and guide you into all truth, because you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. So come on, let's teach this thing early in the morning, because we seek him first, the kingdom of the Most High Yah, and all his righteousness, knowing that all things shall be added unto us. Woo, Most High! I come lifting up everyone on Facebook Live this morning. The ones that are listening live and the ones that will listen later. Have us to yield to your will. Thou kingdom come, thou will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Nevertheless, not our will, but thine will be done. I thank you right now for everything that you're doing in our lives. I thank you that the blood is on the doorposts and you are keeping sickness and diseases away from us as we see these coronavirus cases arising every day. Thank you for giving us knowledge, understanding, and wisdom that you have a shelter in place because you are a shelter in a time of storm. Thank Thank you for being a shield and a buckler. Thank you for being our teachings and our instructions. Thank you for not leaving us comfortless, that you left us with the comforter, which is the Ruach HaKodesh, that will lead and guide us into all truth. Thank you for this day. Thank you for revelation knowledge. Thank you for progressive revelation. Thank you for the very breath that is flowing through our lungs this morning. Thank you that you are the one and only Yah, and there will be no other Yahs before you. Thank you for waking us up this morning, clothing our right mind, that we truly have the activity over our limbs. Somebody didn't get up this morning. Somebody is laying in a hospital. Somebody is waiting for a bed. But right now, Most High Yah, you have chosen us to keep us, sending Raphael with a legions of messengers to encamp around us. We got Michael Warren and the atmosphere. We have Gabriel to bring a message, and we have Uriel to light it up as we walk in kingdom principles for kingdom living. Thank you this morning. Thank you for all that you have done for us and opening our eyes that we may see. You are still giving sight to the blind. We just need to be obedient to your word. Your word says obedience is better than sacrifice. As we continue this series on kingdom principles for kingdom living, I will forever give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And it's in the mighty, mighty name of Yahushua HaMashiach, I pray. Glory to his name. All praises to the Most High Yah. The word says if two or three gather together in his name, that he would be in the midst. The word says if two touch and agree on anything, it shall be done. And I know I can't do nothing this morning without this word being established through the law, the prophets, and the writings. So the method style of study, it is a process of studying the word of Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya, which is I am, that I am in Hebrew, the great I am, the Yah of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we seek his guidance and live in a kingdom lifestyle. The Torah is the Most High Yah's teachings and instructions in 613 principles. It's where the Creator speaks, Mother. And then we search the witnesses through the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvim's, collectively the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvim's, or identify as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title, and is the only book that Yahushua studied and referenced throughout the New Testament. Genesis chapter 10. Verse 21, unto Seth also, the father of all the children of Eber, the brother of Josaphat the elder, even to him were children born. Today we look to the word father, Abba. Hebrews 1, Av, head or founder of a household, group, family, or clan, ancestor, or producer, generator. The Torah testifies, Genesis chapter 4, verse 21, and his brother's name was Jabal. He was the father of all such as handle the harp and organ. The prophets proclaim, Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 25. Since the day that your fathers came forth out of the land of Egypt, unto this day I have even sent unto you all my servants, the prophets, daily rising up early and sending them. The writings bear witness. Joshua chapter 14, verse 1. And these are the countries which the children of Israel inherited in the land of Canaan, which Eleazar the priest and Joshua the son of Nun, and the heads of the fathers of the tribes of the children of Israel, distribute for an inheritance to them. We have completed the method style of study this morning, reviewing father. First, we recognize the standard set in the Torah in 613 principles. Then we search the witnesses in the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvim. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvim, or identified as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title, and is the only book that Yahushua studied in reference throughout the New Testament. 5 a.m. prayer. The Most High Yah is our King and our Father. We must remain connected to our source, our Abba, who drew us out of himself. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 1. Hear ye children, the instruction of a father, and attend to no understanding. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. For the children are to learn of and from their Abba the ways that they should go. Return now and find what has been missing, your connection to your origin. All right now. So now, are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? Are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? This morning we are coming out of the book of Exodus, which is our constitution. Exodus chapter 20. In its entirety. Again, this morning, we are coming out of the book of Exodus. Exodus chapter 20, in its entirety, and it reads, "And Yah spake all these words, saying, I am the Most High, thou Yah, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt not have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, the Most High Yah, am a jealous Yah, visited the iniquities of the fathers upon the children until the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Most High thou Yah in vain, for the Most High will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Most High thou Yah. In it thou shalt not do any work. Thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thou son, nor thou daughter, thou manservant, nor thou maidservant, nor thou cattle, nor thou stranger that is within thou gates. For in 6 days the Most High made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and he rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Most High blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor thou father and thou mother, that thou days may be long upon the land which the Most High thou Yah giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thou neighbor. Thou shalt not covet thou neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thou neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thou neighbor's. And all the people saw the thunderings and the lightning and the noise of the shofar, and the mountain smoking. And when they saw it, they removed and stood afar off. And they said unto Moshe, speak thou with us, and we will hear. But let not Yah speak with us, lest we die. And Moshe said unto the people, fear not, for Yah is come to prove you, and that his fear may be before your faces, that ye sin not. And the people stood afar off, and Moshe drew near unto the thick darkness where Yah was. And the Most High Yah said unto Moshe, thus thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, ye have seen that I, Yah, have talked with you from heaven. Ye shall not make with me gods of silver, neither shall ye make unto you gods of gold. An altar of earth thou shalt make unto me, and shall sacrifice thereon thou burnt offerings, and thou peace offering, thou sheep and thou oxen, and all the places will I record my name. I will come unto thee, and I will bless thee. And if thou wilt make me an altar of stone, thou shalt not build it of hewn stone. For if thou lift up thou too upon it, thou hast polluted it. Neither shalt thou go up by steps unto my altar, that thou nakedness be not discovered thereon. May the Most High Yah add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his most holy word. Father is always working. Ooh, what you say? Father is always working. You better know in this pandemic, Father is always working. The religious leaders, take that word out, please. The religious leaders took Yahushua to task for working on the Sabbath. Yahushua replied, was that he simply was following the example of his father. My father is always at his work. And I too am working. What did Yahushua mean by this statement? Doesn't the second chapter of Genesis tells us that the Most High Yah worked for 6 days in creation and then rested on the seventh? Wasn't that day of rest commemorated and established as a standard for the Most High Yah's people in the Sabbath law? Yet, Yahushua said that the Father is always working. Maybe we have misunderstood the meaning of Sabbath. Ooh, you better come on and teach this thing, Dr. Miles Monroe. Maybe we may have misunderstood the meaning of Sabbath. Perhaps resting on the Sabbath means changing our mode of work, such as enjoying what we work for. The important point here is that Yahushua, as the son of his father, was committed to working whenever his father worked and doing whatever his father was doing. Since the father was always working, Yahushua was always working, whether or not it was the Sabbath. Besides, Yahushua plainly said the Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is the Most High, even of the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is the Most High, even of the Sabbath. Mark chapter 2. Verse 27 and 28. The Most High Yah never intended for us to be slaves. Let's say that again. The Most High Yah never intended for us to be slaves, bound to a strict legalistic interpretation of the day of rest, but to live as free people in doing what is right and good at all times. By word and by example. You better say that again, Dr. J. By word and by example. Yahushua was showed us that it is always right to do good, even on the Sabbath. As children of our Father, we also should be working. Whenever he is working, Yahushua, as our elder brother, has set the example for us. The good work of the kingdom of the Most High Yah never takes a holiday. Ooh, and neither should we. What you say? The good work of the kingdom of the Most High Yah never takes a holiday, and neither should we. Even when we are on vacation, and at other times when we are not at work at our jobs, we should still be working for the kingdom. Too many times when believers go on vacation, they also take a break from the Most High in his work. They don't worship. They don't study the Most High Yah's word. And they don't talk to anyone about the Most High in his kingdom. This is not right. The work of the kingdom never stops. Our Father is always working, and we should be working also. A gift of water. What you say? A gift of water. Yesterday, I was working in my daycare, right? And my hairstylist who does my hair called me, and she says, "Jay, are you busy?" And I said, when I said no, she replied, "I have one of my stylists who is going through a lot, and I was wondering if you could pray for her." She said that she would call me back on a three-way call in a few minutes. So when my hairstylist called back, the young lady began to open up. "I'm at the end of my rope," she confessed to me. "I'm almost at a point of losing my faith. When I woke up this morning, I found out that another one of my aunts had passed away. I have lost 3 aunts in a span of a month." Y'all better come on now, because some folks got some real problems that's going on. She told me she was pregnant, and she just found out that her baby will be born with severe birth defects. Her uncle had also been rushed to the hospital, and the doctors were able to resuscitate him, but they just declared him brain dead, and they will be pulling the plug today, she said. "I'm so tired." So what do you think about that? If our Father is always working, we should always be working. Because we don't know. I'm just sitting in the daycare and I received that call on yesterday. Can you imagine? You know, sometimes we really think we're going through some things. But to have lost 3 aunts over this past month, and now another uncle rushed to the hospital and they resuscitated him, but he's brain dead, so they pulled the plug on yesterday. Then to find out her grandmother had this blood illness where the blood begins to fight against the organs. And so they had to rush her grandmother to a hospital that was 2 hours away. And then here she is expecting, and the doctors tell her that the baby that she's carrying is going to have some birth defects. I had to really look at my life as I begin to minister to this young woman on yesterday. You know, I've been thinking about stuff that I've been going through. You know, sometimes we do. We get in those places where we think about things that we go through. But after all that, I said, Most High, y'all, I don't have no problems. I could not imagine walking through that. But ministering to her about losing her faith, I had to let her know that it wasn't about her faith. It was about the Most High Yah's faithfulness. I know we can say this, but when you're sitting in something like that, we can minister to somebody saying all things work together. But in that moment, when somebody is really at the end of their rope, you got to always be in a position to minister the kingdom of the Most High Yah. So then Yahushua's words, they echoed in my mind. My Father is always working, and I too am working. I knew I had to take time for this woman in need. No matter the time or the place or the circumstances, the Most High Yah is always working. He deliberately puts us in situations where we can minister to people. The Most High Yah is always working. And as his children, we must always be working also. That's what the kingdom is all about. That is what the kingdom is all about. Son of the Most High, Yah, Son of Man. Come on now. Teach this thing, Holy Spirit. Son of the Most High, Yah, Son of Man. Yahushua shocked the religious leaders of his day when he spoke of the Most High Yah as his father. At this time, the Jews generally had no concept or understanding of the Most High Yah as father in a personal way. Therefore, Yahushua's claim of such intimacy offended them. Fatherhood implies source. Say that again. Fatherhood implies source. When we claim someone as father, we claim him as the source of who we are, suggesting we are made of the same stuff. That is what Yahushua was claiming when he called the Most High Yah his father. The religious leaders understood his claim, which is why they persecuted him. Jew theology had no fatherhood image of the Most High Yah. They knew the Most High Yah was holy, just, and merciful, but they also saw him as a terrifying judge, a consuming fire. The Most High Yah to be feared. They did not know or see him as a father. After his unprecedented claim to intimacy with the Most High Yah, Yahushua went on to compare his activities and authority with those of his father. Essentially, they were the same. What you say? Essentially, they were the same. Yahushua exercised the same authority as his father, particularly in matters of life and judgment. For just as the father raises the dead and gives them life, even so, the son gives life to whom he pleases to give it. Moreover, the Father judges no one, but has entrusted all judgment to the Son. I tell you the truth. Whoever hears my words and believe him who who sent me has eternal life. And will not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life. I tell you the truth, a time is coming and has come when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of the Most High Yah, and those who hear will live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son to have eternal, to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to judge, because he is the Son of Man. John chapter 5, verse 21 through 22. Drop down to verses 24 through 27. Yahushua stated that he had the power to give life and the power to execute judgment over men, both of which were purviewed of the Most High Yah alone. It is significant that Yahushua refers to himself as the Son of the Most High Yah in relation to his authority to give life, and as the Son of Man in relation to his authority to judge. Only the Most High Yah can give life. And since the Son of the Most High Yah is of the same essence, the same stuff as the Father, the Son can also give life. On the other hand, the only one qualified or legal on earth to render judgment upon men is one who is an offspring of man. In order to qualify, this offspring must be without sin, because only someone who has no sin of his own can bear the sins of others. No one except Yahushua has ever met this qualification, but he met it perfectly. Born of a woman, born of a virgin, born into the ancestral line of David, Yahushua was a Son of Man because he was fully human. He was, as Paul said, the second Adam. Unlike the first Adam, Yahushua perfectly fulfilled the Most High Yah's original plan. Yahushua did what Adam could not, because he fulfilled his Father's will perfectly and without sin. Yahushua, the Son of Man, was qualified to judge the race of man. He passed that judgment at the crucifixion stake, where he took our sin guilt upon himself, becoming sin for us. You better see 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, and sentence himself to death. After judging our sin as the Son of Man, he was able, as the Son of the Most High Yah, to give us life. Everything Yahushua did in his earthly ministry, healing the sick, raising the dead, casting out demons, calming storms, feeding multitudes with mere handfuls of food, he did under his authority as the Son of Man. It was necessary for the Most High Yah to become a man in order to unleash his love and power in the earthly realms. By design, the Most High Yah gave dominion of the earth to mankind. And only humans have legal jurisdiction here. That is why whenever the Most High Yah wants to do something in the earth, he seeks to work through
human agents.
And Yahushua, he has the perfect man to initiate his work. What does this mean to us? Come on now. Wake up this morning. What does this mean to us? It means that even though Yahushua was the Son of the Most High Yah, in the flesh, he had no inherent advantages over us. Many of us tend to assume that because he was the Most High Yah in the flesh, Yahushua was better equipped than we are. This is not so. Yahushua had the same human stuff we do. He had a physical body that got tired and knew pain. He needed regular rest, just as we do. He got hungry and needed food, and thirsty and needed drink. He faced the same temptations, yet never failed to sin. He operated under the power of the Ruach HaKodesh and later gave that same spirit to us. In everything he did, he claimed his authority as Son of Man, because we have the same stuff. We have the same authority on earth. Everything he did, he claimed his authority as the Son of Man. Because we have the same stuff. We have the same authority on earth. In HaMashiach, we are authority on earth because we are human, just as he was. Y'all better come on, because he said to us, now until John the Baptist, come on now, greater works shall you do. A kingdom of ignorant kings. What you say? A kingdom of ignorant kings. The problem for so many of us is that we don't know who we are. What you say? The problem for so many of us is that we don't know who we are. We have become a kingdom of ignorant kings, ignorant of our identity, ability, power, and authority. Long ago, we forgot, if we ever knew, all that the enemy stole from us. Deposed, defeated, and dejected, like the prodigal son, we sit in the mud in the stench of pig tree, nibbling on dry corn husks, never lifting the eyes of our spirit to behold the riches of our father's estate that are ours if we would only reach out and decree them. Our greatest enemy today is neither Hasatan nor sin, because Yahushua defeated both at a crucifixion stake. Power is not the problem either. We have power. That is why the Most High Yah did not send power to fix our problem. You better talk about it this morning, Ruach HaKodesh. Power is not our problem either. We have power. That is why the Most High Yah did not send power to fix our problem. Our greatest enemy today is ignorance. The very elect would be deceived. My people are destroyed from lack of knowledge. Our greatest enemy today is ignorance. What we don't know is killing us. Say it again, Dr. J. What we don't know is killing us, or at least depriving us of a full and abundant life. The antidote for ignorance is knowledge. And what is knowledge? Information. Come on now. Wake up this morning. Wake up this morning. The antidote for ignorance is knowledge. So the Most High Yah sent us his word, his living word, in the person of his son. HaMashiach came to remove our ignorance about the Most High Yah and his kingdom, and to teach us of our inheritance and kingship as children of the Father. As long as we live in HaSatan's darkness, we will never know that we are prisoners in our own territory, slaves of an illegal disport. We will never know we are the rightful rulers of this planet, or that the devil is already a defeated enemy, because we don't know any better, because we don't realize the power we have. We allow HaSatan to run our lives, ravaging our bodies with sickness, draining our finances, destroying our marriages, messing with our kids with drugs and alcohol, and generally wrecking havoc. Yahushua is the light of the world. And we are on the heels of Hanukkah. Hanukkah starts December the 11th through December 18th. Yahushua is the light of the world. Light means knowledge. He came to show us who we really are and to expose the enemy's false kingdom. To put it another way, Yahushua came to introduce us to ourselves and to call us to become the people of the Most High Yah always knew we could be. He came to call us home. Daniel chapter 7 verse 18 says that the saints of the Most High will receive the kingdom and will possess it forever. Say it again, Dr. J. Daniel chapter 7 verse 18 says that the saints of the Most High will receive the kingdom and will possess it forever. Yes, forever and ever. A lot of believers are confused about the word saint. Break it down, Holy Spirit. Teach us. Teach us this morning. Teach us this morning. A lot of believers are confused about the word saint. Some have been taught that saints are super spiritual believers who live high above the place of everyone else and were rewarded this exalted title after their deaths. In truth, every believer is a saint. When the Bible used the word saint, it refers to every child of the Most High Yah, every person who has entered the kingdom through faith and trust in HaMashiach as Savior and the Most High. If you are a believer, you are a saint. And if you are a saint, you are an heir to the kingdom of the Most High Yah. The word saint comes from the same root as the word sanctify. Ooh, you better come on, Holy Spirit. The word saint comes from the same root as the word sanctify. To be sanctified means to be set apart for a specific use. Ooh, see, y'all got a religious term for sanctify, filled with the Holy Ghost. Come on, Most High Yah. To be sanctified means to be set apart for a specific use, to be reserved for a special purpose. Ooh, I'm sanctified, set apart for a specific use. To to be reserved for a special purpose. Think about you or your parents. Wedding china. Think about your or your parents. Wedding china is a set. It's set out for use on a common daily basis. Probably not. Fine china is usually reserved for very special occasions, such as feast days, Er Shabbat dinners, when extended family members gather, or when particularly honored guests are present. In this sense, the china is sanctified for use only on those occasions. In the same way, we as saints are sanctified and set apart for the Most High Yah's special purpose. Collectively, we are the church, the ekklesia in Greek, which also means the called out ones. Ooh, y'all better come on. If y'all have not realized nothing else in this pandemic is that the Most High Yah is calling us out of something. The church doors are locked. Ekklesia in Greek means the called out ones. We are the ones who will receive the kingdom. We are the ones who will see our power, authority, and dominion restored. The kingdom is not reserved for us alone, but for many, many others as well who are still outside and need to be brought in. That is why when HaMashiach brought us out and brought us into a kingdom, he made us ambassadors so that we could go out and bring others in. What you say? We are ambassadors so we can go out and bring others in. All praises to the Most High Yah. Oh, I'm always working because my Father is working. You better get an understanding that the kingdom of the Most High Yah needs to be taught. He sent out his Talmudim into the highways and byways, and he said, teach this message, the gospel of the good news, which is the kingdom message. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Teach what? The message of the good news of the kingdom. Come on now. You are the church. Ekklesia in Greek. It means the called out ones. Come out from among them. Modern day Babylon, pagan idolatry worship. Come out from among them. You got to come out now. Hallelujah. I think the Most High Yah just commissioned you as an ambassador. Thou kingdom come, thou will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. He's telling you on this day, I will give you the keys of the kingdom. Come on and bind some stuff in the earth, because I'll bound it in heaven. Come on and loose some stuff in the earth, because it will be loosed in heaven. You are children of the Most High Yah. He is our Father as we pray. Our Father which art in heaven. Hallowed thou be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done.
Ooh, it's all about the Father. Glory to your name, Most High Yah, this morning. Glory, glory, glory to your name. Did you catch the revelation?
Did the scales fall
off of your eyes? Are you getting it now? Thou kingdom come. Thou will be done. On earth as it is in heaven.
Woo! Thank you, Most High Yah.
Thank you for revelation. Because revelation precedes deliverance.
Ooh.
Somebody getting delivered right now. Somebody ain't never heard the good news. The gospel of the good news, which is the kingdom of the Most High Yah. We are kings and queens, and we have been given the authority to rule and reign in the earth realm. Thank you, Yahushua. Greater work shall you do. Because greater is he that is in me than he that was ever in this world. Greater works shall we do. And here are your next five principles under the eighth commandment. Ooh, this is so good. Oh, baby, this is better than a fried turkey, a smoked turkey dressing, sweet potato pie, candy yams, all whatever y'all doing today. It's much better than them collard greens with a smoked turkey leg in it. It's sweeter than honey in a honeycomb. Y'all better taste and see that the Most High Yah is better than your banana pudding. Come on now. Hallelujah. And he gets gooder and gooder. He's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. I love him more today than I did on yesterday. Glory to his name. Principle number 465. You shall leave the gleaning of your field. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 9. Principle number 466. You shall not pick the undeveloped twigs of your vineyard. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 10. Principle number 467. You shall not gather the fallen fruit of your vineyard. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 10. Principle number 468. You shall leave the fallen fruit for the poor and the proselyte. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 10. And principle number 469. You shall leave the undeveloped twigs of your vineyard for the poor and the proselyte. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 10. Oh, taste and see that the Most High Yah is good.
Now connected to Esther's iPhone.
And he gets gooder and gooder.
Thank you, Most High Yah. Hallelujah.
If I should ever leave and want to go, please don't close your door on me.
Oh, should go astray. Bless your name, Most High. Bless your name. All praises to the Most High, Yah. Bless you, Queen Robbie, Queen Karen. Who else up in here? Queen Regina, King Raynard. Bless you. I'm sitting here saying to myself, woo, this the way you start off your day. This is the way you start off your day. You always put him first. Always put him first. The word says to seek him first, the kingdom of the Most High Yah, and all his righteousness, and all things shall be added unto us. All right now. Woo! Hallelujah. I'm thankful. I'm thankful to the Most High Yah for his word. It's his word. His word does not return void, neither shall it be reversed, and it will do exactly what he sent it to do. Thank you, Queen Gina. Thank you for standing in prayer with me. Yes, pray for this baby girl. Pray for her. You know, I just see her as one of our children. She's a young girl. So pray for her. Pray for her. Bless you, Queen Karen, beautiful one. I sure enjoyed your presence this morning, Queen Karen. I just feel your spirit, sister. So bless you, and you have an awesome, blessed day. And Yah is going to do amazing things in your life. He's opening doors that no man can shut, and he's going to shut a door that no man can open. So, Queen Karen, you get ready for that, sister. You get ready for it. And one thing about walking in the word of the Most High Yah, you know, coming out of religion, we don't do no naming and claiming and stuff. You a queen, Queen Karen. You better decree some things in your life, beautiful one, and walk that thing out by faith and not by sight, because we are children of the Most High Yah, and we know faith in Hebrew mean obedience. So you just keep being obedient, because obedience brings the blessing. I don't know where all that came from, Queen Karen, but I'm just going to flow in what the Holy Spirit was telling me to say to you. But anyway, I've been feeling your spirit all morning. So bless you, Queen Karen. I am so happy you were here this morning. Queen Robbie, you know I love myself some of you, girl. Queen Gina, bless you. I love you so much. King Raynard, brother, come on. You just steadfast. You just, the Most High say to you, just be steadfast. Just keep standing in it. Trusting and believing, brother. He got you. He got you. You walking some things out. Things in life for you are changing, and the wisdom that the Most High Yah is giving you now. So you applying those things to your life. So application is everything, King. So you keep applying it, and you keep seeking. You keep seeking, and the Holy Spirit will speak to you himself. The word says no longer will you need a teacher. Okay? The Holy Spirit is your teacher. And the Torah is a tutor. Imagine that. So yeah. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Even though we do not celebrate Thanksgiving, so nobody better throw up in these comments, happy Thanksgiving, Dr. J. We're going to have some problems. Okay? So even though we do not celebrate Thanksgiving, you know, people try to turn it, well, I'm just being thankful. But you're still doing it on the thankful day that the world set aside, that is called Thanksgiving. And they set them Indians down at the table and then slaughtered them. It was a massacre. How can we be thankful for that? They went in, you know, they always going and killing folks. They, you know, went over there, took us, put us in slavery. We ain't going to talk about them today. We just not going to do it. But we're not going to celebrate things that we're not supposed to celebrate. Hallelujah.
Oh, King Raynard. But
truly feeling the conviction. Bless you, King. Bless you. So, we don't celebrate Thanksgiving, y'all. And if y'all are doing it, please get a revelation. It talked about ignorant kings. Mm-hmm. A kingdom of ignorant kings. Out here talking about I'm celebrating Thanksgiving. A kingdom of ignorant kings. You better get the revelation. Yes, you better get the revelation. We need to stop doing stuff, and we need to come out of pagan idolatry worship, because that's what it is. We are on the heels of Hanukkah. Hanukkah starts December the 11th through December 18th. So please don't come with your happy holidays after Thanksgiving, Merry Christmas, and all that kind of stuff, because we're going to give you a teaching on Santa Claus. Name wasn't Santa Claus. They changed that. It was Santa Claus. Ooh. So we've been doing some stuff we never should have did. But that's because of Christianity. You know, they sold us on a Jesus. That ain't his name. His name is Yahushua. We could be here all day. I could run it to you, baby. I could run it down. Because you need to know this. My people are destroyed from lack of knowledge. And y'all out here talking about some happy Thanksgiving. And the next thing you know, we're talking about some Merry Christmas. That's what we're not going to do. So please, I love you. But do not put no happy Thanksgiving in these comments or a Merry Christmas. We don't do that. Mm-mm. Hanukkah, the festival of lights. Yahushua is the light of the world. He calls us children of light, not children of a Christmas tree. Now, he told Jeremiah not to bring a tree into your house and decorate it. Don't fasten it to with nails that it stands up straight. Come on now. Why we didn't get that about Christmas? Because it was a feeling. It made you feel good.
You know, them snickerdoodle cookies was
cooking. Mama baking sugar cookies. You know, the whole house smelling like a candy cane. It was the feeling. And that's how the enemy gets you real subtle. He comes through your feelings. He won't make you feel good. Child, no. We sanctified, set apart, reserved for a purpose. That just sounds like kingdom. You know what I'm saying? When you learn what the terms in the Bible really mean, the definitions of the real word, Hebraically studying that thing, you'll be like, what? Girl, get out of here. I don't want your sanctification. I'm sanctified in the kingdom. I'm on reserve. That's what he does. You better come on here, Queen Karen. We celebrate holy days. That's right. Passover. Come on now. The Feast of Unleavened Bread. Purim. I mean, all those feast days are in the Bible. And he tells you, according to Ezekiel chapter 44, he says a real prophet, teacher, pastor, will teach the clean from the unclean, the holy from the unholy, and the feast days, the Moedim's of the Most High Yah. So if your pastor ain't teaching the feast days and not keeping the Sabbath, child, you better run as far as you can. He is a liar and ain't no light in him. Emotions on the commotion. You better come on in here, Queen Robbie. We did some ignorant stuff, y'all. And see, I'm not talking about folks. I'm talking about myself. I did it too. I was at grandma's house under the Christmas tree talking about where my present at. All up under the tree. I think one year I wrapped myself up and said, I am the present. I remember that, y'all. I was all wrapped up. Merry Christmas, baby. He showed it to me right. You know all them songs. And see, what happens is those songs start playing in your little head. They attach to your emotions. And then the enemy comes in real subtle. For surely he didn't say not to bring a Christmas tree in your house. For surely he didn't say not to celebrate Thanksgiving. It's just a day of being thankful. You're telling everybody you're thankful. You're thankful that you didn't get COVID during this time. You better stop at Hasatan. We got the blood on the doorpost. That's why we ain't got no COVID-19. Passover, we put the blood on the doorpost. I'm so thankful. You need to be thankful every day. Y'all set aside one day to be thankful.
All right now.
All right. Who got the recipe to the sweet potato pie? Look at Dr. J. Who got that recipe to the sweet potato pie? We still got to eat today, child. Shoot. We're going to eat anyway. We just ain't celebrating no doggone Thanksgiving. But we're going to throw down today. Who got the recipe for that good old sweet potato pie? I'm talking about down south, where it stands up a little bit tall and it got that butter in it, but you got to have that Atlanta Lake butter. That's what y'all got this morning. Y'all got sweet potato pie from the word of the Most High Yah. Oh, taste and see that the Most High Yah is good. Praise Almighty Yah, for he winks at our ignorance. Oh, that's good. That's good, Queen Karen. Praise Almighty Yah, for he winks at our ignorance. But when you know the ways of the Almighty Yah, you better walk like you know it. I know that's right, Queen. I know that's right, Queen Karen. But when you know the ways of the Most High Yah, you better walk like you know. That's authority. That's authority right there. Hallelujah. All right, I love you guys. Tomorrow we gonna start at we're gonna start prayer at 9 a.m. tomorrow. Look at Dr. J trying to get some sleep. We're gonna start prayer tomorrow at 9 a.m. Mountain Standard Time. So if you're on the East Coast, that's 11 o'clock. If you're in down south Mississippi, where my family from on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, it's gonna be 8 o'clock, King Raynard, down there on that Gulf Coast. Yes. So tomorrow, we're going to post a whole lot of posts. So y'all, come on now. Don't think we're not having it. Because, you know, sometimes we wake up at 5 in the morning. We don't see 5 a.m. prayer. I'm like, oh, they're not on today. Tell everybody 5 a.m. prayer will start at 9 a.m. tomorrow. And 9 a.m. is the appointed time of prayer, which is beautiful. Okay? So that's what time we're going to start tomorrow, 9 a.m. Y'all be here. Now, y'all going to get you a little rest. You got all these days off. One thing about this pagan, being in this pagan world, child, we get some rest days. I'll be like, girl, please, Thanksgiving. What? Child, we going to sleep. We going to sleep, child. So, tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. So, that's 8 o'clock your time, King Raynard. Shalom, Golden Gulf Coast. You know I know. Ugh. I'm so sad that I don't get to travel like I was traveling to the Mississippi Gulf Coast and teaching right there at the Centennial Hotel in Gulfport. I miss it. I can't wait till the Most High Yah releases us to travel to teach again. You heard what I said, didn't you? I can't wait till the Most High Yah releases us. Not no vaccine. I can't wait till the Most High Yah releases us where we can travel again. Nobody taking no vaccine. You crazy? That's what we not gonna do. Don't y'all take that vaccine? Mm-mm. We gonna let all the ones take it first. We gonna let all them guinea pigs go first. Y'all go ahead. We gonna sit back. The children of Israel are gonna sit back and watch like this, like. We gonna sit back and just watch, child. We ain't doing that. We gonna let y'all go first. Go ahead. You can go. Oh. Can you cut the line? Oh, child, you are the line. Go on, child. Go. Can I cut in front of you? Yes, go ahead. Cut on in front of me. Go on, take that vaccine. That's what we're not going to do. So, y'all keep being faithful and obedient to the Most High Yah. And I'm telling you, he is the one that is keeping sickness and diseases away from us. Right now here in Colorado, we still need to use wisdom. And I don't know what's going on in your state, but you need to be using wisdom. Right now here in the state of Colorado, there are no more beds in the hospitals. Did you hear what I said? Anybody on here from Colorado? There are no beds in the state of Colorado. Now you can keep going out here acting crazy. Not washing your hand, touching your face, don't have no mask on, no 6 feet social distancing. First of all, you're supposed to be in the house. What you doing outside? Shelter is in place. And that's the Most High Yah. So yeah, it's not good right now. You know, one of my daycare parents is a nurse. And when she showed up last night, she said, I really need you to be safe. I need you to be safe. I said, girl, I got a shelter in place. What you talking about? I got blood on the doorpost. And she was telling me there are no beds. The hospital she works at yesterday, when she came to my door, there was only 2 beds left. And I'm sure them 2 beds have been filled.
We need to take this serious. We really do. Mm-hmm. Queen Robbie, you got that right. We've been guinea pigs for far too long. Tuskegee Airmen. We're going to take y'all and inject syphilis in you, and then we're going to do a whole study on you. No, that's what you're not going to do with us. That's what you're not going to do. So we need to be careful. Seriously. Y'all stay away from folks. Only be with folks that is in your household. And in the state of Colorado now, we're down to you can only have 5 people in your house. 5. So that means ain't nobody coming over today, right? And you ain't going over nobody. First of all, you ain't celebrating no Thanksgiving, so what you doing? At somebody's house. You better get yourself in the house and stay in the house where there is shelter in place. And it's the word of the Most High YAH. And that's what we believe. We choose to believe the report of the Most High YAH. So y'all can keep reporting all that and COVID and all that. We choose to believe the report of the Most High YAH. And you already know how serious it is. It touched super close to home. My son in Arizona was tested positive for COVID. And I thank you guys for praying for my son. He's better. And I think he a little bit too much better. He 25, think he invincible. He done became Superman, child. I know he out there doing something. He ain't got no business. And I said, Trey, you still have to stay home, even if you're feeling better. But yes, my son tested positive for COVID. And then my sister, her whole house, her sons were playing on the football team or whatever. And one of the little boys tested positive for COVID. And then her whole house, they're sick. So keep praying, y'all. But use wisdom. Please use wisdom. I love y'all. Just be wise. Just be wise. Be the 5 wise virgin, not the 5 foolish virgin with no oil in your lamp. See, we the 5 wise virgins, and the oil in our lamp is the Torah. The audio cut out, Shay. Did it? You can't hear me? So, I don't know what that is then. Okay. Thank you, Queen. Thank you, Queen Gina. Thank you. So may the Most High YAH bless you and keep you. May the Most High YAH make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Most High YAH lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. So they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them. Hallelujah. So get to the Blogspot, get to Facebook, get to YouTube. It will encourage you. Have a supernatural day 5. I love you, love you, love you. Ooh, I love you. You know I love you. Bye now. So good. So good.